Assalamu alaikum children. Welcome to the science class for the grade 5. This is Galaxy course book in science which we are following. So today we are going to start lesson number 1, plant reproduction. So children, in your previous classes you have studied about the properties of living things and non-living things. So in our surroundings, we find living and non-living, both the things, natural and man-made. You have studied in class 3 and 4. So in living things, what are the properties? Living things need food and water to grow. It needs to breathe the air. It grows bigger in size. It can respond to the changes. Okay, children, it respond to the changes and it reproduce. So what is reproduce? What is reproduction? Reproduction means producing the young ones of its own kind. As living things reproduce to increase in number, so as plants are also living things, plants, animals and human beings, these are living things. So they are having the property of reproduction to increase their number. So in this lesson, we will see plants as living things, how they reproduce. At the end of this chapter, you will be able to discuss various ways by which plants reproduce, and you will be able to explain the process of germination and seed dispersal. Okay, children, let's start our lesson. Plant reproduction. Plants are living things. They reproduce and increase their number. Plants reproduce in different ways. They reproduce through seeds, stems, roots, leaves and spores. As you have studied that in a plant, the parts of the plant, there is a root system and shoot system. Below the surface of the earth, there is root system, and above the surface of the earth, shoot system will be there. In that, stem, leaves, branches, leaves, fruits, flowers, all these things will be there. So here plants reproduce through the seed, stem, roots, leaves and spores. So we will see by the different means how plants reproduce. So first one is growing plants from seeds. Many plants bear flowers. You might have seen on many plants flowers will be there. Flowers develop into fruits that have seeds inside them. New plants grow from these seeds. Different plants have different kind of seeds. Seeds are in different colors, sizes and shapes. Some of the seeds, such as cardamom, have a sweet fragrance. You might have seen cardamom smell, its fragrance will be sweet, which we use in various desserts. So children, to know more about seeds, here one activity is given in your textbook. So activity is, from your kitchen you have to collect different types of seeds, such as peas, kidney beans, chickpeas, coriander, black pepper and red chilies. In the red chili also seeds will be there, that you have to collect. Compare their color, shape and size. So here are some different type of seeds which you can easily get in your kitchen. So collect these seeds and see, observe the difference in color and shape and size. Okay, children. So now we will see, why do plants produce so many seeds? In the fruits, you might have seen in some fruits, only one seed will be there. In some seeds, in some fruits, three, four seeds will be there. And in some fruits, multiple seeds will be there, like pomegranate and figs. Okay, children. So plants produce many seeds because all the seeds do not grow into new plants. Why plants grow new number of seeds? Because every seed cannot become a new plant. So some seeds only, in the favorable conditions, it grows into a new plant. Some seeds do not grow into plants because of the following reason. So we are saying that every seed will not become a new plant. So some seeds will become a new plant and some will not. So what is the reason for some seeds which cannot grow into new plant? So here are the reasons. They are not healthy. The first reason is, if seeds are not healthy, they cannot grow into new plant. They are destroyed by wind or heavy rains. See, in the gardens or the plants or trees, when it gets heavy rainfall, its
fruit and flowers can destroy because of heavy rainfall or fast blowing air. They are eaten by insects and birds. Okay, children, in the garden and the farms, many insects and birds, they sit on the plants and they eat fruits and flowers. So every seed will not become a new plant. And the reason, they do not get the right conditions to grow into plants. So to become a new plant, a seed need a favorable, some favorable conditions, suitable conditions, like a proper rainfall, proper temperature or sunlight, whatever the things they need to become a new plant. If they don't get the favorable conditions, they cannot grow into new plant. The seeds that survive and find favorable conditions grow into new plant. With seed, get favorable conditions and get to survive. So it can only survive and can grow into new plant. Let's see now parts of a seed. So to learn about parts of a seed, we need to perform this activity. The aim of this activity is to study the parts of a seed. So materials which we required, a few beans, seeds and water in a bowl. We need some bean seeds and water in bowl. Method, take a bean seed and observe it closely. You will see a hole in it. Air can enter the seed through this hole. Which hole you can see on the seed, actually air enters from here. So it allows the seed to breathe. Now soak the seed in water overnight. Observe the seed in the morning. You will notice the seed has become soft. After soaking in the water, the seed will become soft. It has a thin cover, outer covering called a seed coat. Remove the seed coat. Under the seed coat, you will see two seed leaves called cotyledons. When we break this soaked seed, so in the, it will divide into two parts. That is called cotyledons. Between the seed leaves, you will see the baby plant, very small plant-like structure you can see. That is called embryo. Okay, children. So the cotyledons store food for the plant body. So these cotyledons, two leaves you can see, they store food for baby plant. The baby plant uses this food till it grows its own roots and leaves. Once the food in the cotyledon is used, the cotyledons shrink and fall off. Okay, children. The young plant now starts making its own food through photosynthesis. Okay, so how a plant, baby plant comes out from the seed and how it grows by preparing its own food. So preparation of food, as plants are the producers, they produce their own food through the process of photosynthesis, which you have learned in the previous classes, children. What is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is actually the food making process in plants. In their body itself, the food prepares. In which part? Plants prepare their food in the leaves. So in the leaves, as you know that chlorophyll is present, and in the presence of sunlight, when plants make food and they need water, minerals and carbon dioxide, which carbon dioxide they absorb from atmosphere, water and minerals they get from roots, and in the presence of sunlight and the presence of chlorophyll also, they prepare food. So this food making process in the presence of sunlight is called photosynthesis. Okay, this is the process of photosynthesis. This is food making process for the plants. Now we will see seed germination. How does a seed grow into a new plant? Just now we have seen the parts of a seed. Now we will see how does a seed grow into a new plant. The process by which a seed starts growing into a seedling, this process is called germination. A seed needs right conditions in order to germinate. So in favorable conditions, a seed can grow into new plant. So children, it was the reproduction through the seeds which we have seen today. So in the next lesson, in the next session, we will see growing plants from stems and roots. Okay, that's it for today's video. Then in next video, we will continue in the lesson plants, plant reproduction part 2. You will see next video. Till then, take care. Goodbye. Thanks for watching.